they'll wipe them out, but the mean leaf beetles have to take a bite of the plant. That's the thing, because those products that you're putting on the seed, the insecticides, like your Trilex or your Cruiser, they have to move through the plant, and that bug has to take a bite to get that.
Now, if you don't control those bean leaf beetles right away when they emerge from the soil and they start feeding, they're going to reproduce, and you're going to have a generation of bean leaf beetles that'll probably show up midsummer. It all depends on what area of the country you're in. The farther north you go, the fewer generations we have per year. The farther south you go, the more generations we have per year. So in other words, you can have these bean leaf beetles that show up early in the spring. They're going to show up again in the middle of the summer. And then they're going to show up a lot of times in August in our part of the country. And when they do, and we've got pods on the plants, I mean, it's a little early right now for this, but we want you to know about it today. So you start looking here over the next few weeks. If you have beetles showing up and they're clipping off your pods, that's where we get really concerned.
Well, you can absolutely see the yield loss out in your field when you see pods laying on the ground. And it's not uncommon to see bean leaf beetles, even in lighter infestations at this time of year, clipping off lots of pods and literally taking bushel after bushel off your yields. So you really need to consider, what is the cost of spraying these bean leaf beetles, because the damage is pretty evident.
Well, it is, but there is other damage that can be caused too, because bean leaf beetles are usually a carrier for bean pod model virus. And even if they don't carry that disease, when they feed on the plant, they open it up for any disease to get in. So they can be a real concern with pod feeding, a little bit with the leaf injury, and a lot with the disease problems that they can bring into your field.
As far as treating bean leaf beetles, you may think, wow, this is a huge problem, and it's probably going to cost me an arm and a leg to treat bean leaf beetles.
Nope.
Fortunately, it's really pretty inexpensive. Just about any of the insecticides on the market are pretty effective, especially the pyrethroids, and you can use the lower end labeled rate. So oftentimes, bean leaf beetle control may only cost $2 or a little more per acre. And you say, well, wait a minute, why wouldn't I do it? Well, once you get beans that are fully canopied and you've got big bushy beans, you may question, gosh, am I going to hurt my yield by driving through the field? If you've got road beans, you know, you wonder about that. Am I going to tangle some of those beans along on my sprayer? Should I get an aerial applicator? Is that a big concern?
The whole thing is, you got to look at this economic threshold, and like Darren said, if it only costs a couple bucks to spray, no big deal. The problem becomes if you have to hire a plane for $8, that really jacks your cost as compared to if you can spray yourself for $1 or $2.
Oh boy, it's going to cost a bushel and a quarter to protect
it.
I can see the yield loss out there in the clip pods.
Yeah, I'm just saying, I mean, if you had maybe one bean leaf beetle per 10 plants, you can probably justify it pretty easily if you're spraying yourself, but you might have to go to one per 8 plants or one per 6 plants or something like that if you're going to have a plane. Well, I'm just saying,
it does take a little bit more, but it isn't